गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ब्लैक डायमंड पब्लिक स्कूल गादी का टोना जमुई बिहार। एंड टुडे माय टॉपिक इज टीचिंग थिंकिंग स्किल। सो आई एम गोइंग टू एलेबोरेट ऑफ दिस टॉपिक। सो एट फर्स्ट वी विल सी द डेफिनेशंस ऑफ दिस टॉपिक। थिंकिंग स्किल्स, क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग स्किल्स, दोज हु टेक पार्डन एट फर्स्ट टूडेज वी विल डिस्क्राइब द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट ऑफ दिस टॉपिक्स। थ्रू आउट हिस्ट्री फिलोसफर politicians, educator and many other have been concerned with the art and science of astute thinking. Some identify the spirit of inquiry and dialogue that characterized the golden age of ancient Greece as the beginning of this interest. Others point to the age of enlightenment with its emphasis on rationality and progress. In the 20th century, the ability to engage in careful reflective thought has been viewed in various ways as a fundamental characteristic of an educated person, as a requirement for responsible citizenship in a democratic society, and more recently as an employability skill of an increasingly wide range of jobs. Deborah Goves, what quoted at the beginning of this report, typify the current viewpoint in education about the importance of this teaching. Today's students to think critically and creatively virtually all winters on this subjects discuss thinking skills in connection with the two related phenomena of modern technology and fast paced change. Robinson, for example, state in her 1987 practicum report, teaching children to become effective thinkers is increasingly recognized as an immediate goal of education. If students are must to be equipped with lifelong learning and thinking skills necessary to acquire and process information in an ever changing world. Byth, Moram, etc., 1987 underscores these points, characterizing thinking skills as mean to making good choices. Thinking skills are necessary tools in society characterized by rapid change, many alternatives of actions, and numerous individuals and collective choice and decision. The societal factor that create a need for well-developed thinking skills are only part of the story. However, another reason that educator, employers and other call for more and better thinking skills instructions in school that American young people in general do not exhibit an impressive level of skill in critical or creative thinking. The following observations from Norrish 1987 reviews is typical. Critical thinking ability is not whispered. Most students do not score well on tests that measure ability to recognize assumptions, evaluate argument, and appraise inferences. Likewise, Robinson notes that while the importance of cognitive development has become whispered, student performance on measure of higher order thinking ability has displayed a critical need for students to develop the skills and attitude of effective thinking. There is yet another major force behind the call for improved thinking skills instructions. Educators are now generally agreed that it is fact possible to increase students' creative and critical thinking capacities through instructions and practice. Risto, 1988, notes that in the past these capacities have often been regarded as a fluke of nature, a genetic predispositions, qualities are either possessed or not possessed by their owner, and that education can do very little to develop these qualities. Risto then goes on to say, however, a great deal of research currently being reported indicate that the direct teaching of creative skills can produce better, more thinking thinkers. Precisians make this point ever more forcefully, asserting that the most basic premise in the current thinking skills movement is the notion that students can learn to think better if schools concentrate on teaching them HWO, how to do thinking skills, critical thinking, creative thinking, higher order thinking. Those who take an interest in this field of study soon realize that they cannot go tossing off this term in a casual manner, since there are no universal agreement as to their precise meaning. Critical thinking, for example, has been variously defined as reflective and reasonable thinking that is focused on deciding what to believe or do in is quite in precision. The dispositions to provide evidence in support of one's conclusion and request evidence from other before accepting their conclusion. The process of determining the authority's accuracy and worth information or knowledge claim. Byers goes on say that critical thinking has two important dimensions. It is both a frame of mind and number of specific mental operations. Starting that having a critical spirit is more important thinking critically, that critical spirit acquires onto thinking critically about all aspect of life, to think critically about on thinking, and to act on the basis of what one has considered when using critical thinking skill. List of alternative definitions could also be generated for other terminology commonly used in thinking skills literature in attempt to come to term with these definitions differences. Alvino, those not universally accepted by their risk and program development. Four purpose of the present report. These definitions are applicable. They include Bloom taxonomy, popular instructions model of developed by the prominent educator Benjamin Bloom. It categorizes thinking skills from the concentrate to the abstract knowledge, comprehension, applications, analyze, synthesis, as evaluations. The last three are considered higher order skills. Cognitions, the mental operations involved in thinking, the biological, neurological process of our brain facilitates throughout. Creative thinking, a novel way of seeing or doing things that is characterized by four components: fluency, flexibility, perspective easily, originality or elaborations. Critical thinking, the process of determining the authority, accuracy or value of something, characteristic by the ability to seek reason and alternatives, perceives the total situations and change on view based on evidence, also called logical thinking and analytical thinking. Infusion, integrating thinking skills instructions into the regular curriculum, infused program or commonly contrasted to separate programs, which teach thinking skills as curriculum itself. Metacognitions, the process of planning, assessing and monitoring on's one thinking, the pinnacle of mental functioning. Thinking skills, the set of basic and advanced skills and sub skills that govern a person's mental process. These skills consist of knowledge, depositions and cognitive and metacognitive operations. Transfer, the ability to apply thinking skills thought separately to any subjects. The thinking skills research. This summary is based on review of 56 documents. 36 of these are reports of search, studies of review and are sites with annotations in the key reference sections of the bibliography. 23 are descriptive, theoretical or guidelines documents are concerned with research in areas other than the effective of programs and practices. These reports are itemized in the general references. Of the 33 documents, 22 are research studies or evaluations and 11 are review or synthesis of research. Subject of these investigations includes general students populations, 12 report elements students, 9 secondary students and both secondary and post secondary students. The research involved regular gifted EMR and chapter 1 students populations, a representative range and racials, ethnic group and balance of urban, suburban and rural settings. Only 3 of the reports deal with students populations outside the United States. Five of the reports has teachers as well as students as their subjects. Effects on students' outcomes. Thinking skills instructions enhance academic achievement. Broad thinking skills instructions enhancing academic achievement. A broad general finding from the research base is that nearly all the thinking skills programs and practices investigated were found to make positive difference in the achievement level of practicing students. Studies which looked at assessment over time found that thinking skills instructions accelerates the learning gains of participants and those with true or quasi experimental designs generally found that experimental students outperformed control to significant degree. Report with such finding include Barba and Merchant 1990, Bass and Perkins 1984, Bransford Hassler 1985, Horton and Reba 1986, Hodgins and Edemans 1986, Kagan 98, Marshall 1987, and Riding and Powell 1985-1987 and Robinson 1987. So Shadow, Snap and Glover 1990. Research report instructions many specific skills and technique. Gain or learning and intelligence measure were noted in response to providing instructions in a variety of specific technique including study skills such as paraphrasing outlines, developing cognitive maps and using advanced organized shape of Glover technique, etc., all 1989. Creative and critical thinking skills, such as decision-making problem, solving fluency, observations, explorations, classification, generating hypotheses, Schlichters and Park 1988, Hermstein, etc. 1986, Horton and Reba, Kagan 1988. Research support the use of several specific thinking skills programs. The research consulted in the preparations for this report is not all inclusive, and no doubt there are studies and evaluations supporting the effectiveness of program other than those identified here. The following programs are cited there because they are widely known and used are representative of kinds of thinking skills programs in current use in schools and have been studied by research program found to effective include comprehensive school mathematics programs. This is an elementary level math curriculum that focuses on classifications, elementary logic and number theory. Children use computer and calculator and geometry models to pass course problems, explore concepts, develop skills,
and define the ideas. CORT, cognitive research, intended for use for students of any age or level. Program develops criticals, creative and constructive thinking skills over the 3 year period. HOTS, higher order thinking skills. HOTS is a computer laboratory program for chapter 1 and other elementary students. It uses rapidly available computer software in concert with specific teaching practices to enhance skills in metacognition, influencing, and decontextualization, that is, taking something learned in one setting and applying it to another. Institute for Creative Education. ICE is a creative problem solving process for students in grade K-12. It develops student ability to apply the creative thinking quality of fluency, flexibility, originality, and elaborations to problem solving. Instrumental engagement. Upper elementary and secondary students engage in cluster of problem solving tasks and exercise that are designed to make students active learner and enhance their general learning abilities. Steinberg and Vanna. Kids interest discovery study. Kids elementary schools conduct a survey of a student interest, and based on results, students engage in active self-directed learning and highly level thinking around selected topics. Odyssey, for use by upper elementary or secondary students, these programs focus on 6 aspect cognitive functions, the foundations of reasoning, understanding language, verbal reasons, problem solving, decision making, and investigative thinking. Philosophy for children, designed to develop thinking and reasoning skills throughout classroom discussions, philosophical topics. The program is organized around 6 novels in which children apply philosophical thinking in their daily lives. The curriculum spans entire K-12 range, problem solving and comprehension. These programs concentrate on 4 problem solving components: documents, skills, vocabulary, basis arithmetic, operations, and precise thinking. Student work in problem solver instance pairs. The program is frequently used in conjunction with other thinking skills programs. SAGE is designed for gifted elementary students and extend the regular curriculums throughout, incorporating thinking skills development activities, mini studies unit, and independent studies. SOI, based on Gulford structures of intellect theory. The program is organized around the development of 120 intellectual skills from foundations level to higher order
and emphasize reasoning as the key component of successful learning. Talent Unlimited is designed for elementary students and help participating develop multiple thinking skills. Teachers receive training to instruct their students in productive thinking, decision making, planning, forecasting, communications, and knowledge based development. Think secondary students engage in problem solving activities in which they are encouraged to discuss the rationales leading to their conclusion, consider of other point view and analyze various reasoning process. Training teacher to teach thinking skills lead to student achievement gains, developments, and researchers of most of the effective programs cited above claim that teacher's training is a key factor in the program's success. The majority of these programs have a strong teacher's training components and development consider this training to be as important as the program content in bringing about the learning gains noted. Programs, strategies, and trainings are important, but in drawing conclusions about the effectiveness of particular thinking skills, instructional strategies, whole programs or staff development approaches, several resources also offer a schedule to those who might take curriculum decisions based on the information. Essentially, they say yes, these programs practice and training activities can be effective, but their effectiveness is partially depends on factor other than the methodological themselves. In a typical expressions of reservations, Stenberg and Vanna at the conclusion their 1986 review of several thinking skills programs write, the success of given program depends on a large number of implementations, specific factors such as quality of teaching, administrative support, appropriate of the programs for the student populations, and the extent to which program is implemented in the intended manner. Stenberg Vanna's observations about the match between program and students' populations also serves to remind us of another truism. Just as there is no one certifiably best approach to teaching many other things, there is no one best way to teaching thinking skills. At the end of study, comparing different approaches to teaching critical thinking, Bass and Perkins write, like so much educational research, or final results were not supporting just one instructional technique. The controversies in thinking skills instructions. It is better to teach thinking skills to students via infused program or separate curricula.
it is it better to teach these skills directly to create situations whereby the student learn them inferentially throughout being placed in circumstances which call for them to apply the skills. How much classroom time is required in order for thinking skills instructions to be effective? That is, for student to master higher order skills and be able to transfer them to other learning context. Is successful thinking skills instructions partially a matter establishing a STEM classroom climate, one that is open and conducive to thinking for oneself? Differences of opinions, sometimes profound ones, have been expressed by their register that developed and classroom teachers. In response to these questions, what does the research say? Infuse versus separated program. On the demonstrably effective programs itemized above, about half are the infused variety and the other half are taught separately from the regular curriculums. In the additions, while several documents in the thinking skills literature activities into subjects in the regular curriculums are the Matthew in 1989, Pogro 1988 and Begum 1990 provide support for separate thinking skills instructions. The strong support that exists for both approaches, not to mention in the view of varying expert, indicates that either approach can effective. Freshmen represent what is perhaps a mean of reconciling these references when he writes all the conclusion of the 1990 study. Thinking skills need to be taught directly before they are applied to content areas. Consider the concept of teaching thinking skills directly to be value, especially when they are followed immediate applications to concerned area. In a similar view, Bransford 1986 says, blind instructions in which students are not helped to focus or general process or strategies, not to understand how new concepts and strategies can function as tool for problem solving, does not usually lead to transfer to new tasks, as the instructions focused as helping students become problem solvers who learn to recognize and monitoring their approaches to particular task transfer is more likely to occur. Direct versus inferential learning approaches such as inquiry development and the technique used in the HOTS program involve guiding students through the process of figuring out what strategies to apply and where those strategies can lead them. Some researchers and developers pogros often evidence that this approach enables students to learn thinking skills rather than merely learning about them. HOTS program developers Stanley Pogro can call the process control flundering because students must feel their way, but controlled because teachers stay with them and assist them to walk throughout to step of their tasks. Other steps, direct instructions in the steps, whatever thinking process the teachers want to students learn. Teachers using this approach typically demonstrate the process using evident events and ideas which are familiar to the student and applying the same generic process to unfamiliar materials. Usually new content from the school's curriculums, proponent claim that many students cannot be expected to develop these skills inferentially and must be taught them directly. The efficacy of direct instructions in a variety of thinking skills is demonstrated in the work of Freshman, Hornstein, etc., Pearson's 1982 and Wong 1985, among others. Again, it would appear that either approach can be effective and blend out of the two many well be most effective persons. For example, favor both direct instruction and guidance practices. I think the justifications exist for placing more emphasis on direct explicit teaching alternatives discussions, substance feedback and control, and self-monitoring strategies. Time equipment for thinking skills instructions. This topic is not so much that subject controversies as a uncertainty. Even the expert seems uncertain as to how much time should be devoted to thinking skills effective in order for students to learn those skills well. Of course, time requirement will be different for different students and experience, so that some students becomes adept thinkers with no explicit instructions at all. The research can only address the time questions obliquely, since most researchers don't design studies in which different group of students are exposed different amount of instructions. What the research does show is that those commercial or logically developed programs which have made substantial differences in students' academic performance are quite time intensive. Instrumental enrichment requires 3 to 5 hours of instructions as per week over approximately 2 years. Philosophy for Children, or K-12 curriculum, calls for the 3 40-minute period weekly. Odyssey, made of 100 to 45 minutes lessons. Programs such as HOTS, which are designed specially for at-risk students who have limited experience in or understanding and applying higher order strategies requires ever more time. Pogro 1987 says, it takes an extensive amount of time to produce result at least 35 minutes a day, 4 days a week, for several months, for true thinking skill development to occur. Given these kinds of time demands, conducting meaningful thinking skills instructions clearly require a higher level of staff commitment and administrative support. Classroom climate. Research shows that positive classroom climate, characterized by the high expectations, teacher warmth and encouragement, pleasant physical surrounding and so on, enhance all kinds of learning. In the thinking skills illiterate, there is an especially strong emphasis on the importance of climate, or call calm 1989. Go so far as to say that teachers and administrators should systematically evaluate the general culture of their classroom and schools and should estimate how these calculate affect their ability to promote critical reasoning habit among students. The points made by these returns and many other is that moving beyond one mental habit and experiment with new ways to looking. The point made by these writers and many other is that moving beyond one's mental habit and experimental with new ways of looking at things. The very stuff of thinking skills instructions involve risk in order for students to be willing to participate in such activities. They need to feel free to explore and express opinion, to examine alternative positions on controversial topics, and to justify beliefs about what is true and good while participating in all orderly classroom discourse. Here again, research can provide illuminations only indirectly. However, it is the case that the validate programs in the research base include both teachers training components and classroom activities which emphasize establishing open simulating supportive climate. How might this be accomplished? Take this leads to well recommended teachers behavior, all of which will be familiar to good teachers. For fostering a climate conducting to the development of thinking skills, setting ground rule well in advance, providing well-planned activities, showing aspect for each student, providing non-threatening activities, being flexible, accepting individuals' differences, exhibiting a positive attitude, modeling thinking skills, acknowledging every response, allowing students to be active participants, creating experiences that will ensure success at least part of the time for each student. Using a wide variety of teaching modalities. And now we will see that abstract. A course was developed to teach cognitive skills that apply to learning and intellectual performance independently of subject matter, sensing, observations and classification, reasoning, critical use of language problems, solving, inventiveness and decision making with protest and post-test. It was taught experimentally to over 400 Venezuelan 7th grader whose classes were matched to those of control group. Although evaluation of such a course is conceptually difficult and long-term effects have not been assessed. Standard and social objective test and various subjective test indicates consistently that his course that sizable beneficial effect on its students. Interest in classroom teaching of generally useful thinking skills has increased markedly. The prospects of improving intellectual and workshops and inventions programs developed in several countries have recently been reviewed under the auspices of the National Institute of Education. These articles describe one such program that was distinguished by an elective approach to the conceptual structures of the curriculum and relatively extensive evaluations of results. The programs described here was initiated by the Venezuelan government, which requested the assistance of Harness University. From the onset, the collaborations also included researchers at Bolt, Burnett and Newman, and in the Venezuelan Ministry of Education. The larger program in Venezuelan, in which of this project was a part, was described in Science and in the APA. Although the course materials were developed for Venezuelan schools, in particular the 7th grade, and much attention was given to ensuring the appropriateness of the material to that culture, they have since been published in English. The course of designed to enhance performance one on a wide of variety tasks that require carefully observations and classification, deductive or inductive reason, critical use of language, hypothesis generation and testing, problem solving, investiveness and decision making. The focus was on cognitive skills that apply to learning and intellectual performance independently of subject matter. Rather than conventional academic content, skill that can reasonably be considered to be component of intelligence and that are sufficiently well designed to lend themselves to explicit instructions were the target of the course. The design and preparations of the course materials began in the fall of 1980. About a dozen experiment Venezuelan teachers worked with the project. Project staff during part of summer of 1981, becoming familiar with the materials and suggesting modification. Some of these teachers later trained the Venezuelan teachers who would actually teach the course in its final form, at which time they supervised the classroom teaching during the second academic year 1981-1982. Some of the material was tested in Venezuelan classroom and evaluated informally by the teachers, after which the material was further modified. Also, during that teacher, the remainder of the course was prepared as were the testing instruments that were to be used for formal evaluations of the course during the academic year of 1982-1983. Various tests of mental abilities were adapted, developed and used during the second year. Two main purposes were served by the testing at this stage. The first was to assess the feasibility of the test and to adapt them where necessary for Venezuelan 7th grader. The second purpose was to find a school in which the disturbances of the test score was sufficiently similar to permit the sectional of the comparables experiment and control groups. For the third year, besides several standard tests of general aptitude, some 500 test items reflecting the involving content of the experimental course were written, of which about 70% were administered to samples of school children. The resulting target abilities test as well as the final set of standard mental ability test are described later. The experimental course. The course as finally composed contains 6 lesson series, each of which addresses a topic that the project staff considered to be important to intellectual competence. Each lesson series is divided into 2 or more units that focus on specific aspect of series topic. Each of the 20 tenets continuous of interactions between teachers and students to provide a model of how to be teaching and evaluating score. The course doubt. The approximately 100 lessons prepared were more than could be taught in a single year given the scheduling and time constraints under which the course was presented in anticipation of the need for compressions. We selected approximately 60 lessons to represent the course coverage. 56 lessons were actually used during the final evaluations year, as shown in table this one. In general, the class met 4 days a week. Succeeding lessons were used on 3 of these days. The 4th day was devoted to review or completions, uncomplished regions, local, the city of Barquisimeto was the site of the experiment. This city of approximately 4 lakh inhabitants is the capital of the state of Lara in the central region. Venezuelan and it's approximately 300 kilometers southwest of Caracas. In consultations with Venezuelan associate, we decide to use classes only in a school classified by education authorities as barrio schools, or designations that indicate that the school children come from families of indicates that school children come to the families of low socioeconomic status and minimal parental education. Of the 12 Barquisimeto schools thus designated by the appropriate grade of level, 4 were eliminated from the appropriate grade level. 4 were eliminated from the federations either because of the insufficient number of 7th grade sections or because of standardized test scores obtained during the preliminary phase of the study. Suggested that the student population tested higher than the student population in other barrio schools. From the remaining 8 schools, 3 pairs, 6 schools were identified as good matches in terms of school size, physically layout, and type of neighborhood. Thus, it was considered appropriate to use these schools to make up the experimental and control group. Students, 24 7th grade classes from these 6 schools, 4 from each school participated in the final administrations and evaluations of the course. Each class had approximately 30 to 40 students. 12 the classes from each of 3 schools were designated experimental classes, and 12 classes from the 3 remaining schools were designated control classes. The experimental group containing 463 students were control group contained 432 students. All the participating classes from a given schools were either experimental classes or control classes. No schools had classes in both categories because of the way students are assigned to classes of given grade. In Venezuelan classes, variety of considerably in a average student is experimental classes were paired with control classes so as to equate as nearly as possible the average student as in the 2 classes of each pair. The largest difference between the
So these are the basic informations about the teaching skills
teaching thinking skills. Thank you.